Healing Heifer was Geraland S.H. Lauren Rainbow, shown by Elgin View Cattle Marketing. And in second, Death Haven Redline Arena, shown by Stephen, Deborah, Danielle, and Patrick Hoyer. And the final class, you just saw her won, Flower Brook Giddy's Gwyn, shown by Andrew Stewie. And in second, Death Haven MH Tri Mally ET, shown by Stephen and Deborah Hoyer and Marilyn Hay. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the best heifers of Minnesota for the 2011 state show. Let's all give them a round of applause. Thank you, exhibitors, for bringing us the best.
Music with him.
Most correct and fit the kind of heifer that I like here today. We have a tremendous winter calf here. I think a calf that's very, very correct. She has that show style, and she's followed by our fall calf, who's a setup similar type. Again, a heifer that's just a tremendous stylish heifer. She's got that balance and quality throughout. Our summer yearling, again, a heifer that's really, really a dairy heifer, a heifer that's very flinty of her bone and flat of her bone. We have our big junior yearling here, a heifer that maybe today is carrying a little extra condition, but a heifer when you get in and analyze her is a very, very correct heifer, a heifer that can do well in both the black and whites, obviously, and the red and whites this year. And then we have our senior yearling here, a big strong heifer, a heifer that's hard topped and very, very correct and correct on her feet and legs. But for me, ladies and gentlemen, when it comes down to junior champion today, the heifer that I think that is the kind that everybody would like to own, we've got to go with this fall calf. The calf is just a fantastic, correct, stylish calf. And I'm going to follow her for reserve today with a heifer that I think types in quite well with her, that can handle a lot of heat. And that's going to be our winter calf here for reserve. And we're going to follow her from, we'll mention, with her summer yearling. A heifer that types in quite well with those other two heifers. I think they're heifers that are peas in the pod. Not to take anything away from our other two heifers here today, but I think these three are our best three heifers of the day. Congratulations.
This is a senior 3-year-old sound class, there were 17 animals exhibited. He'd like to mark your catalogs. Entry 1901 placed first, if she was best friend owned, TJ Holloman, Redliner Shania Red, exhibited by Brooke Holloman and Quentin Scott. 1904 was 17. 1905 was 8. 1906 placed 3rd. 1907 was 13. 1908 was 9. 1909 was 15. 1910 scratch. 1911 was 11. 1912 was 14.
Congratulations, Carl.
1913 was 5th, and our production award winner. She is Stewie Dundee Gabrina E.T., shown by Andy Stewie. At 3 years, 11 months, and 305 days, she produced 33,653 pounds of milk, 1,278 pounds of fat, and 996 pounds of protein, for a total dollar value of $4,346.03. Entry 1914 was 4th, 1915 was 2nd and the best udder in the class, 1916 was 12th, 1917 was 7th, 1918 was 16th, 1919 was 6th, and entry 1920 placed 10th.
Anna and Emma Culbert say. There were 9 animals exhibited in the junior 2-year-old class. 17 cows were shown in the senior 2-year-old class. First place to first glance talent contest exhibited by Mary Franz. And second place to Lake Prairie Kite Anika shown by Joseph Stronsky and Lydia Olson. 13 cows competed in the junior 3-year-old class. First place went to Macland Cleaver Stacy, shown by Scott Culbertson. And in second place, Holmgren Talent Montana ET, shown by John and Rachel Holmgren. And just winning the large class of 17 senior 3-year-olds was TJ Palama Redliner Shania Red, shown by Brooke Palama and Quentin Scott. Second place went to Lida Acres Damian Amber ET, shown by Dana and Maria Johnson. Let's please all give a strong round of applause for the winners of this today's Young Cow Classes. Yeah. And now for his selection of intermediate champion, here is Judge Craswell.
Well, once again, ladies and gentlemen, in these young cow shows, class, as you can see, just tremendous group of cows. And again, the exhibitors, I feel, are to be commended. Just a great group of cows that we've had to look at here this morning. I've settled on these final five here. I've gone with my two senior two-year-olds. Beautiful, beautiful udder tappers, tremendous frame tappers. And then we've got a junior three-year-old here, a great, great uddered cow, tremendous femininity about this cow. And then our two senior threes, just tremendous, tremendous uddered cows. For me, at the end of the day here today for intermediate champion, when I look for the one that I think best puts that total package together, today for me it's going to be this senior three-year-old. When I look for the cow that I feel is the most correct from part to part here today that's going to go along with her, I'm going to go with our first place junior three here for the reserve. And we have to mention our first place senior two-year-old for honorable mention, a beautiful young cow. Now again, not to take anything away from the two that are left, because I brought them out here because I feel they're very, very worthy as well. Congratulations to our winners.
It is my pleasure to introduce you to the animals competing for senior champion of this year's show. Once again, please show your round of applause and excitement for maybe your favorite cow as they walk around the ring. Leading off with the four-year-old cows, winning the class was Jen D. Devil Tiffany Red, shown by Reed Stronsky and Jennifer Dingbaum. In second was Demmer's Lucifer Pamela, shown by Demmer Farms. Winning the five-year-old class was Savage Lee Dundee Lou E.T., shown by Tony Coles. Second in the class was Benner Dundee Corey, shown by Dana and Maria Johnson. Winning the age cow class was Blonded Lister Beauty, shown by David and Jeremy Hazy. In second was Bud John Rubensonette, shown by Megan Herbert. Winning the 125,000-pound cow class was Rodash View Durham Jazzy T, shown by Roger and David Fries. And in second, C. Hill Paris, shown by Jason, Katie, Whitney, and Tristan Lane. Place unfresh two-year-old was Tri-Spring Lightning Dancer, shown by Elgin View Cattle Marketing. The second place unfresh two-year-old was Budjon J.K. Phoenix Roxanne E.T., shown by Callie Strobel. The first place dry 3 and 4 year old was Omar Shottle Dainty, shown by Brian and Jill Nelson. Working with cattle and the people in this industry is something Brian truly enjoys, and we are so thankful that he has taken the time to serve as our official judge of this year's Minnesota State Show. Let's give our judge, Brian Craswell, a round of applause.
Thank you.
Judge Craswell, we are anxiously awaiting your selection of this year's senior champion.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a great honor to judge this show here today. To me, it's just been a fantastic show. We've seen cows at different stages, but very well presented. And I'd just like to thank you for the opportunity to be here and do the show. And I think that the exhibitors and the fitters and the breeders and everybody involved deserves a round of applause. Well, at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, I guess we're not done yet, but when we're here in the senior champions, we have four, for me, cows that are really, really good cows. I'll start at this end. We have the 125 cow that, to me, is a cow that, just a true type model cow, a cow with a tremendous udder, a cow with tremendous balance, a cow with no major faults. And then we have our mature cow, an extremely tall, long dairy cow, extremely dairy cow, quality, quality, quality from end to end. And then we have our pair of four-year-olds. Again, our second place cow, a beautiful dairy cow, cow that exemplifies dairy quality from end to end, and our great, great udder winning cow of the class out here, the four cows. Sometimes when you get asked to judge, sometimes you wish you'd stayed home, but in general, it's a great honor, folks, to be able to ask to be placed these animals. And probably the best teacher I ever had was my father. And he said at the end of the day, he said, you judge the cows, you judge what you see, and stay true to yourself. And for me, ladies and gentlemen, the kind of cows that I like are the cows that are the cows with the least faults. And for me, the cow with the least faults today that looks like a true type model cow is this 120. Just a beautiful cow. And for reserve, this tremendous long dairy, great udder cow for reserve. And we're going back to our great udder 4-year-old from Comanche. Congratulations.